Welcome. Welcome to the National Life Group Do Good Fest 2023. Things look a little different this year. They just look a little bit different for obvious reasons. But we want to thank you for joining us. We're super excited because, well, we're streaming it live. You can find that at dogoodfest.com. It is live on Star 92.9. And we welcome WCAX as well. It is live tonight until 9 o'clock. We have some great music lined up and ready to go as well. If you are watching and you are sitting comfortably in your home, we ask that you make a donation. You can make a donation at dogoodfest.com for flood relief. And if you were affected by the floods, we do hope that you can enjoy a few hours away from the chaos and just take a pause and try to have a good time. We want to welcome, we do have a studio audience here in the concert cafeteria, I'll call it the concert caf. And a lot of people that are here tonight were affected by those floods. Multi-generation businesses are here. We want to thank you for taking time to come here, and we got you. I want you to know we got your back. I also want to welcome Kat and Darren from WCAX. Mike Zarni, my morning show partner, is here as well. I'm Mary Sensi from Mike and Mary in the Morning on Star 92.9. Mehran Asadi and Beth and his whole team here at National Life Group put a lot of effort into making sure this went on today. So let's give a round of applause for them, to the people who are here. Thank you. VP of Operations for Star 92.9, John Mullett, put a lot of effort into this. And then I want to welcome Ken Barlow and his wife Lori, owners of Star 92.9, here as well. So I hope you're ready for a fun show. We have so much going on, so much to get ready for. We got the Plain White Tees, Lovely the Band, and Fastball ready to perform a nice acoustic show right here for you in Vermont, on the campus, in the cafeteria at National Life Group. But first, we have the All Night Boogie Band, Vermont's own All Night Boogie Band, ready to start things off for us. A nice, warm Vermont welcome.
How's everybody doing?
We good?
We're All Night Boogie Band from Burlington, Vermont. We're so grateful to be here. We are going to play three songs off of our next album coming out on August 3rd.
Thanks for having us.
Yes, thank you. This is called On the Road.
Wake up in the morning, get right out of bed. Ain't even got time to think. Running off 3 hours of shut-eye. Might even fall asleep if I win. One step forwards and one step back. Can't even get my foot out the door. Well, my mind can't take it, my heart can't fake it no more. Wanna be on the road. Driving in the day and playing at night. It's where my heart feels right. Working my fingers right down to the bone. By 5 o'clock they just might bleed. I got no choice, I gotta pay my bills, but a gig is really what I need. When the sun goes down and I hit the town, I'ma step onto the stage and play. I spend all day grinding, but a good night is coming my way. I wanna quit my my job, I just want to be free, but I ain't got a dollar to fold. The bossman said he's got to have a word with me, but it's a story that's already been told. I can fuss, I can pout, I can scream and shout, still I never get paid what I'm owed. I got one for the money, two just to go on the road. Wanna be on the road. Driving in the day and playing at night. It's where my heart feels right. Wanna be on the road. All night long I'll be singing this song. It's where my heart feels right.
Thank you so much. That one's called On the Road. This next song is coming out on Wednesday, July 19th, called Don't Come Around Here No More.
Dear my baby, listen to me. I've heard about the things that you've been doing without me. Well, I threw your love on the floor, and your stuff is at the door. Don't you think about coming around here no more. Oh, my darling, listen to me. Oh, even a child can see that you've been cheating on me. Well, it's too late now, go. Don't pretend like you don't know. Don't you think about coming around here no more. Now listen here, people, take it from me, nobody, and I mean nobody, deserves to feel what I feel. If they don't treat you right, the way it's supposed to be, don't waste your time. Think about coming around here no more. No more, baby. No more.
Thank you so much. That one's called Don't Come Around Here No More. Coming out on Wednesday, like I said. We're All Night Boogie Band. We're from Burlington, Vermont, and we are really, really grateful to be here to help raise money for people who were affected by floods, businesses, farms, And we're just really grateful to be here for our state that we love so much. Yeah. So like I said, we have an album coming out on August 3rd. This next song is already released. It was our first single we released to announce the album. It is about being a woman in a man's world, and about how unity can help us rise above that and create equality for everyone. It's called Yes, I Am.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We love you, Vermont. In times of turmoil, unity brings us all together, you know?
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. We're All Night Boogie Band.
Their music, wonderfully done. Absolutely great way to kick off this fundraiser, which we know is absolutely needed because as anyone who's been watching the news, reading the news, listening to the news over the last week in our state knows, it's that a lot of Vermonters are stepping up, but a lot of Vermonters really need our help stepping up.
Yeah, Vermonters do what they do best in these times, and that is helping their neighbors. And we are happy to report, we're what, 15 minutes in, and we already have $14,730.
And that,
thank you, Vermont.
All goes to the Vermont Community Foundation's Flood Response and Recovery Fund, which, you know, we hope to grow that number a lot through the course of the evening here.
Open your wallets, open your hearts, folks. A lot of people out there really need your support tonight. So we're going to talk to the CEO and president of National Life, and that is Mehran Asadi. Please come in. We'd love to chat with you about this event. Thank
Absolutely.
You so much. Thank you
for being here.
And thank you for organizing this.
It's our pleasure.
So
thank you.
Tell us how this came about.
Well, every year in July, we have a concert in our backyard with 10,000 of our closest friends. And this year, obviously because of this tragedy, we just couldn't get it done. So we decided to pivot to Plan B, which was create a fundraiser, help our neighbors, and raise plenty of funds to support our neighbors in Vermont. And of course, National Life has been part of Vermont since 1848. We've been here for 175 years in the city of Mount Pilliar. So my teammates are so innovative, so creative. So what do? Cancel? No. You make lemonade from lemon, and you get a group of outstanding people, people like you guys in media, to join us, team up, and be part of the solution.
Yeah, so talk about that solution then. It sounds like your employees, though, are not just helping with this event here. They're already boots on the ground. Tell us about that.
Well, at National Life, we actually have a benefit for our associates where they can volunteer 40 hours per year, do whatever they want to do within the community. As a matter of fact, a number of my teammates here all muddy because they've been digging people out of their muddy basement and really helping the community and being part of the solution. So I'm so proud of my teammates. I refer to my teammates as having National Life spirit, which is servant leadership and really being part of the solution, no matter what the issue is.
So I have to ask, so why would an insurance company want to jump in at a time like this?
Well, thank you for asking that.
You're welcome.
Because we are an insurance company with a soul, right? We believe in karma. Our values are do good, be good, and make good. My teammates are do-gooders, and they are part of the community. Good companies are good citizens of communities. And you're part of the solution. That's called being a good citizen from my point of view.
How does a team, you have this whole plan for this big concert, how do you pivot like that to turn something like this out?
So for 175 years, this company has been about innovation, having a can-do attitude. So on Wednesday morning, we are sitting around saying, what the heck are we going to do? And it's like, we got to cancel because of what's going on. And all of a sudden, one of our teammates said, you know what? Let's do a fundraiser. Start calling our buddies at 92.9. Start talking to CAX. And let's turn this thing into a major event in Vermont. Everybody's trying to figure out how can we help? How can we be part of the solution? And here we are, 72 hours later, we are raising money for Vermonters, for our neighbors. And we are so privileged and proud to be part of this.
Kat and I are certainly happy to
be
part
of it.
Yeah,
we are happy to be part of it.
CAX is psyched to be here as well.
Thank you for doing this.
Absolutely.
I appreciate it.
Yeah. So, dare I ask you if you have a goal for tonight?
Well, I would say...
Hi.
I would say we're going to be north of $500,000.
Yes.
Woo!
There you go.
We're all hoping that.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. many of our friends from across the country. We have over 40,000 agents, right? For those of you who are not familiar with National Life Group, we are a Fortune 1000 company. We are a top 10 individual life insurance company in US. And yes, we are in this smallest capital in US, but we are mighty and big. And our producers are jumping in and calling in and making donations because they love Vermont, they love National Life Group, and they're do-gooders. Everybody wants to help, and that's what America is all about.
We want to thank you so much.
It's our pleasure.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very
evening.
Much. I appreciate
Thanks
it.
For
thank
hosting
you.
Us.
Can't agree more with what
I
he
mean,
just said.
I mean, everything.
Absolutely. Well, I would love to report this, though, which, you know, because he just gave us that goal.
Holy
we are
smokes.
Now up to $21,341 Woo! So far. Let's keep that coming
yeah.
through the night. But I think a lot of people might be going, okay, where does that money go? We've
yeah.
said the name of, you know, it's the Vermont Flood Response and Recovery Fund. But the Vermont Community Foundation has a lot more to tell us about what that money actually does.
Yep.
And Dan Smith from the Vermont Community Foundation is joining us now. He's going to be explaining where that money goes, how people can access it, sort of thing. Thank you so much for joining us,
yes,
taking the time
you.
Out of your day.
Thank you for being here. Thank you to everybody who turned this event into what it's going to be tonight and for our neighbors in need right now. It's an incredible response, incredible flexibility, and incredible adaptation in a time of crisis.
So Dan Smith, where does this money go?
This money is going to go out to support the emergency responders, or emergency response that's out ongoing. It's going to go out to support the families who are affected. It's going to support the small businesses that have been affected. I just talked with Vince Morocco running the Hippie Chickpea in downtown Montpelier, lost his shop. You know, it's going to go out to support organizations like that, businesses like that on Main Street, up and down the affected communities across the state.
Yeah, and so when people are thinking, okay, I need help and I need the Vermont Community Foundation's help, what does that look like to get them the money down the line?
Well, we build up a coordinated response structure working with federal, state, local actors, non-governmental organizations like Capstone Community Action. I saw Sue Minter just a minute ago.
We'll be hearing from her a little later, yeah.
We work through people closest to the challenges to get the money in the hands of the people who need it most. I should mention the farms that have been affected. Up and down every watershed, you're looking at crops lost, people's livelihoods. Lost. We'll be using the resources to respond to those affected farmers and as well. I mean, every dollar makes a difference that comes through this fund. So if you were that $21,000th dollar. Thank you if you're
$29,876
now. Keep it
Let's
coming.
Keep going. Let's keep going. Every dollar makes a difference. You know, these are the moments, you know, our organization exists to bring people and resources together to make a difference in Vermont, right? But these are the moments. These are the moments when Vermont shines. We step up for each other. You know, your help is a phone call away. Help is across the fence. Help is the next door over. You know, neighbors in Vermont step up for each other and look out for each other. It's part of our culture. It always has been. It was during Irene. It was during the pandemic. And it is today. This week's been incredible.
Yeah, so I wanted to ask you, because obviously people looking around the state are saying this feels a lot like Tropical Storm Irene again. What did you learn from Tropical Storm Irene and the response there that helped you set up this fund so fast this time around?
Well, I mean, you know, the response in Irene was, in terms of the philanthropy, was a matter of weeks, and this was a matter of days, if not hours, in terms of when we had our fund up and running, in order to be able to offer people a way to give back, right? If you can't show up with a shovel, you can send a dollar, you can send 10 bucks, you can send 50 bucks. So we moved quickly, and the generosity has been ongoing, not just from Vermont, but from across the country right now. People are paying attention to what's happening in Vermont. You know, for a long time, a lot of Vermonters have left the state to pursue their future. Once a Vermonter, always a Vermonter. So if you're watching online, if you're streaming live from Mill Valley, California, or Los Angeles, or Washington, D.C., send your money back. You would think about how to give, when to give back. Now's the time to send back to Vermont, and this is a way.
I wanted to ask you, from a personal perspective, though, handing out this much money, what's that like for you, for the Community Foundation?
You know, this is why we exist. If we're not able to make a difference in a moment like this, we're not doing our jobs right and playing the role we should be playing. This is why philanthropy exists. This is why a community foundation exists. It's to look after people who are in need in our communities. And our job is to challenge ourselves to do that all the time. But what makes it work is innovative employers and leading employers who've been here for 175 years, like National Life, companies like that, who are just willing to look out of the out for the people in their backyards and make a difference by shifting this event into the event that the benefit that it's going to be, to see that number keep ticking up and making a difference for Vermonters.
And speaking of that number ticking up, we're now at $30,943. So everybody is doing amazing. And it tells me that a lot of people really do understand the magnitude of the crisis that we're facing here. Do you, obviously it's too early to know the scope of the damage and the cost of it, but based on what you saw during Irene, you know, is there a realistic number that you are looking to try to hit?
You know, I don't know what the number is going to be, because it's never going to be enough. The amount of need and the scope of this impact we're going to be uncovering for weeks and months in terms of the lives and livelihoods affected. You know, we did $10 million worth of philanthropic response in the pandemic. I wasn't at the foundation during Irene, but it was roughly around the same. You know, we'll see where we get and we see where we go. You know, the key is deal with the challenges now, support our neighbors, make sure they get back and make sure they know that people are looking out for them, make sure they get back on their feet, make sure the small businesses get back on the feet, and their farmers get back on the feet. But then also we need to be thinking about the future. We need to be paying attention to our watersheds. We need to be paying attention to the things that are happening in our communities like this that we need to be ready for in the long run.
So after this money is collected, and again, we're hoping it's a lot tonight, what happens then? How do folks apply? What do they need to do to try to access these funds?
We're in day four of the fundraising. We'll be rolling out, I think, the first slate of grants next week, getting dollars out into those local community organizations like the Montpelier Strong, Montpelier Alive Partnership, like the Capstone Community Action, getting dollars out the door so people, so reach out to your local partners. I mean, somebody should be knocking on your door to see what you need, but just know that we're looking out for you. It takes a little time to build this up, to get it out, but it's all going out the door.
Got a logistical question. These tax deductible?
Yes.
Perfect.
They are all tax deductible. You know, you can make a qualified charitable distribution from your IRA. If you're 70 and a half, you can make a tax deductible gift. You can get creative. We can take care of it and get it out the door to somebody who needs it.
Dan Smith, thank you so much, and good luck with the coming weeks and getting those much-needed dollars out to communities.
Well, thank you to Channel 3 and 92.9 for spinning to cover this event and help us raise this money. And thanks again to National Life for for what they've done.
Our pleasure.
Dan Smith, thank you so much.
You.
We appreciate it.
Yeah.
I think we got to get back to some music.
I think we got to get back to some music for sure.
We're all here for that as well.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kat and Darren. Hi, everyone. I'm Amanda Lee from Star 92.9. Thank you all for coming out tonight and making this show possible, because without a great audience like you guys, well, this would be a different event. So thank you for showing your support. And I definitely want to thank everybody over at WCAX for pairing up with us tonight and making this possible. For those of you watching at home on Channel 3, thank you for tuning in. Those tuning in at Star 92.9 and the live stream as well. And for everybody sitting here or sitting at home or maybe driving, make sure you pull over before you do this first. Go online to dogoodfest.com. Take that link. Share it in social media. Text it to your friends. It doesn't matter if they live in town or out of town or out of state. Maybe it's somebody you haven't talked to in a while. If you share that link with them, let them know what's going on in our region. Let them know what's going on in this town. And just to let you know, the funds raised tonight will go to the Vermont Community Foundation's Vermont Flood Response and Recovery Fund of 2023 with a focus on Central Vermont. And before I give any more thank yous, I want to thank all of you. Give yourselves a big round of applause. This is fantastic. It's so great to see all your faces here tonight. I know in years past, we're out on the lawn, and it's an incredible outdoor event. We had to change things up a little this year to make it a little bit different for a very good cause, and we're going to keep it going tonight and get these funds raised. And you know what? Let's bring on our next act. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Fastball.
All right, we're here. Let's hope everybody makes it here. We're doing great.
You ready? Yeah. All right, here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4. Well, I don't want to be president, Superman, or Clark Kent. I don't want to walk around in their shoes, 'cause I don't know whose side I'm on. I don't know my right from wrong. I don't know where I'm going to. I don't know about you. I'll be the ray falling on your fire escape, and I may not be the man you want me to. I can be myself. How about you? Well, I don't wanna make you mad. I don't wanna meet your dad. I don't wanna be your dream come true, 'cause I don't know just what I found. I don't know my sky from ground. I don't know where I'm going to. I don't know about you. I'll be the rain falling on your fire escape, and I may not be the man you want me to. I could be myself. How about you? I could be myself. How about you? I could be myself. How about you? I could be myself. How about you?
Thank you.
So we got some new songs that are going to be coming out probably next year. Let's do a couple of them. Okay. What about the song? It's called Get You Off My Mind. Like, we couldn't call it Off My Mind because we have a song called Out of My Head. So we'll do that later, but... this is called Get You Off My Mind. I've been waiting here for you. Seems like lately it's all I ever do. maybe I'll never learn. But now there's nowhere to turn. What am I looking for? Why don't you open the door? Lost and lonely, not a soul in sight. Arizona, sure gets cold at night. What was that number again? I can't remember the pin. I need to get some cash. I gotta get away fast. I was flying, but you shot me down. Hanging around outside, but nowhere to go. I fell asleep on a bed of lies, dreaming of the girl with the faraway eyes. Woke up to the sound of the radio. I never knew you could be so unkind. Now there's something that I'm trying to find. I need a little something just to get you off my mind. I threw it away. Can't believe that it's true. What am I gonna do? I was flying, but you shot me down. The misadventures of a tragic clown. Hanging around outside with nowhere to go. I fell asleep with the radio on. I never got to hear my favorite song. I had, but nothing to show. Never knew you were the one thing. I flew a little too close to the flame. Maybe I never should have crossed the line. I need a shot of something just to get you off my mind.
Thank you.
All right, yeah, these songs are going to probably be out on an album and after the first of the year in 2024. We do have a live album coming out in October, though. Live from Austin, Texas. Our home, that's where we're from. It's hard to get here from there, as you'll find out.
It's very hard to get here from there. And someone, the guy driving me yesterday said, oh, we like it that way. I guess you do, because there's like two airplanes in, and that's it. One in the morning and one at night. You miss one of those, you're not going to Vermont. So you want to do You're an Ocean? Okay, we're going to play You're an Ocean, but we're going to do a new song, another new song. This song called Hummingbird. It goes like this. One, two. What's the word, hummingbird? What's those voices that you've heard? Spend your days running round. It just brings you down. It just brings you down. You've seen the Taj Mahal at night, and you've seen the Emerald Isle. You've seen the Valley of the Kings and Queens, and you've sailed down the Nile. You've seen everything you can see, still it doesn't make you happy. What's the word, hummingbird? What's those voices that you've heard?
Spend your days running round. It just brings you down. It just brings you down. You've had breakfast with the Dalai Lama, and you've met heads of state. You're surrounded by those parasites who tell you that you're great. You've met everybody, it's true. Someone should introduce you to you. What's the word? Hummingbird has the scene around you blurred. You can run, you can hide from the simple truth inside. Simple truth inside. Are you afraid of what you'll find? If you sit still with your mind, sit still with your mind. Ow, ow.
Thank you.
Just on a little vacation out to the beach in Texas. It sounds great, but it's not that great. It's Texas beach. Anyway, we were watching a little bit of Disney Plus, and we watched them film Johnny Tsunami. We watched Johnny Tsunami the other night. I don't know if you know what that is, but it's a Disney movie, TV movie from, I think, 1999, and it's got three Fastball songs in it.
Three?
Yeah, it's got Fire Escape.
What?
Yeah, Fire Escape, The Way, and You're an Ocean.
Didn't realize that.
Yeah.
I have
and
to watch.
And it's Vermont is featured in it,
what?
By the way.
Really?
Yes, yeah. Johnny Tsunami's about a kid who gets transplanted by his selfish father for work reasons. And the kid's a surf nut. He's a surfing freak. And he's really good, but he says, well, we're going to move, and you're going to go to school, and I'm going to work at this school, and it's in Vermont. So he goes to this academy.
What part of Vermont?
I don't know, where they ski. Because he meets all these people, and they ski at his school, and they're really hoity-toity, right? But then he meets the public school kids, and they're snowboarders.
Right.
Right? So the snowboarders accept him. Right, because he's different. But the hoity-toity skiers, they don't really like him
very
much.
They don't like him.
So somehow he reconciles everything and, you know, makes a lot of friends. And it's a great movie. I love it.
Does he start breaking into houses with these
it's
snowboarders?
It's got bad. He doesn't do. No, they don't do
They're not
do
a criminal
crimes.
Element? No.
No, see, all their prejudices are unwarranted.
Okay.
Yeah, they're stuffy. Anyway, this is a song from that film. Which we've won many awards for. This is called You're an Ocean. Can you make it easier for me to understand? You're holding my heart in your trembling hand. Eyes that rise to meet me halfway. stars. You may be from Venus, but I'm definitely not from Mars.
You're an ocean.
You're an ocean. Settle down, settle down. What's a commotion?
I'm an island.
You're an ocean. It's a stormy sea of
love and emotion.
You got me suspended motion, less in time. Make the warm wind circle around my head just like you do. If I could do it, I would be doing it to you. I believe I'd buy whatever you would sell to me. Nothing in my life ever came with a guarantee.
You're an ocean.
You're an ocean. Settle down, settle down. What's a commotion?
I'm an island.
You're an ocean. It's a stormy sea of
love and emotion.
You got me suspended motion, less in time. I believe I'd buy whatever you would sell to me. Cause nothing in my life ever came with a guarantee.
You're an ocean.
You're an ocean. Settle down, settle down. What's a commotion?
I'm an island.
But you're an ocean.
It's a stormy sea of love and emotion.
You got me suspended motionless. You got me suspended motionless. You got me suspended motionless in
time. Thank you. Thank you very much. We're going to do another brand new song, ladies and gentlemen. Could I get a little more guitar in this monitor? I guess that's good. There's no volume on this, so. Yeah. This song called America.
I play bass on this. I don't really know how to play this.
It's true. He's the bass player, so. Dun, dun. Just do that, yeah. Here we go. America is hard to see if you only see it on TV. Looking for someone to blame. The picture doesn't fit the frame. Life is not just black and white. Life is not just left and right. America is hard to see if you only see it on TV. Just a dream. A million different neighborhoods. Not all of them are Hollywood. In the
it's hard to see if you only see it on TV. What can we do when everything is red or blue? We may not see eye to eye. I'm sure that you're a real cool guy. Stop and take a look around. Maybe we'll find common ground. America is hard to see. America is you and me.
Thank you. Oh, look at the time. We are Fastball from Austin, Texas. We would love to come back and play for you guys again. We are going to be on tour this summer, so please check it out. I think we're playing close, but I'm a Texan, so take that with a grain of salt, because 500 miles is close. So we're going to do a song called Out of My Head Now. Wait a minute. I want to be perfectly in tune for you. And feel free to sing along.
Here we go.
Sometimes I feel like I am drunk behind the wheel of possibility, however it may roll. But give it a spin, see if you can somehow factor in. You know there's always more than one way to say exactly what you mean to say. Was I out of my head? Was I out of my mind? How could I ever been so blind? Waiting for an invitation, it was hard to find. Don't matter what I say, only what I do. Never mean to do bad things to you. So quiet, but I finally woke up. If you're sad, it's time you spoke up too. Out of my head, was I out of my mind? How could I ever been so blind? Waiting for an invitation, it was hard to find. Don't matter what I say, only what I do. I never mean to do bad things to you. So quiet, but I finally woke up. If you're sad, then it's time you spoke up.
Thank you so much. We got one more for you.
They made up their minds. They started packing. They left before the sun came up that day. An exit to eternal summer slacking. But where were they going without ever knowing the way? They drank up the wine, they got to talking. They now had more important things to say. And when the car broke down, they started walking. Where were they going without ever knowing the way? Anyone can see the road that they walk on is paved in gold. It's always summer, they'll never get cold. They'll never get hungry, they'll never get old and gray. You can see their shadows wandering off somewhere. They won't make it home and they really don't care. They wanted the highway, they're happier there. Today, today. Their children woke up and looked around the house and they couldn't find them. They'd left before the sun came up that day. They just drove off and left it all behind them.
Leaving it all behind.
Where were they going without ever knowing the way? Anyone can see the road that they walk on is paved in gold. It's always summer, they'll never get cold. Never get hungry, never get old and gray. Can see their shadows wandering off somewhere. They won't make it home and they really don't care. They wanted the highway, they're happier there. Today, today. Walk on is paved in gold. It's always summer, they'll never get cold. Never get hungry, never get old and gray. You can see their shadows wandering off somewhere. They won't make it home and they really don't care. They wanted the highway, they're happier there. Today, today. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Amazing. Amazing.
It was amazing.
Let's hear it for Fastball, y'all. Fastball. Good evening. I am Mike Zarni.
I'm Mary Sensi from Star 92.9.
We are Mike and Mary in the morning on Star 92.9. Welcome to National Life Group Good. Do Good Fest 2023, a little bit different this year. We all know what's going on with the flooding.
That's right.
You know, driving down here, coming down 89 South, seeing ponds still in farm fields, seeing train tracks completely destroyed right off the side of the highway, yeah. Under repair.
Yeah, seeing the side of the road just kind of disappeared. You're like the side of the highway,
yeah.
Just missing, yeah.
And State Street here in Montpelier, just a mile away, is where most of this catastrophic damage occurred. I shouldn't say most, because there's multiple areas in the state, Montpelier, Ludlow, NEK,
that were affected by this storm that hit us on Tuesday.
So speaking of that, because we are raising money for flood relief, helping the Vermont Community Foundation, Vermont Flood Response and Recovery Fund, they've already upped the total. Right now we've raised...
Look at that!
What? How much?
$100,913!
That's right.
That's awesome.
Thank you so much, and we appreciate that, but you know what? It's just not enough.
It's just, you know, there's so much work that needs to be done. There are businesses and homes filled with mud, volunteers, people trying to clean all this stuff out, but it's going to take time. It's going to take money.
And a lot of people, like, they want to know, what do we do? Where do we go? How do we, you know, how do we help out, right? So that's why we are here today with Katie. We're going to have Katie Trouts come up.
Katie, from Montpelier Alive, welcome. How are you? Come on over here, and there's where all the people are, right there. And we got Peter Walk, volunteer director, and you're the director of Montpelier Alive.
That's correct.
Tell us a little bit about what you do.
Well, normally I run the downtown revitalization program called Montpelier Alive, working alongside the city on revitalization projects, beautification, and... In fact, I feel like this is really the meaning of my work, the
revitalization. Your job just got a lot harder.
Yes, it got a lot harder. We're really digging into that revitalization, trying to help support businesses throughout this.
I have to say the website has so many resources right now for people to turn to, and all I kept thinking is Wednesday morning or Tuesday.
Tuesday, yeah.
You need help right away, not next week, not in 3 days, like immediately, and your organization helped with that and still does.
Absolutely. From day one, we've been on the ground working with volunteers and raising money and supporting businesses throughout this disaster.
So, Peter, you're in charge of the volunteers, which a lot of people may want to volunteer, but they don't know how.
Sure. We are one of many volunteer organizations around the state trying to stand up, and it's really as a group of community members coming together, trying to help their friends and neighbors to be able to recover, to be able to find some sense of peace, to feel supported through this effort. That's really what we've been working on here. We had over 2,000 volunteers register with our just sort of quick sort of pickup basketball game version of volunteer work as of earlier today. And we're just trying to help everybody get connected where the needs are and help our fellow communities where they need help in organizing and other things.
Yeah, so that's what I was thinking. Like, what is the process if somebody wants to volunteer? What happens? Like, you register, and then do you send them somewhere?
Sure. So we've, in very short order, starting on Tuesday, as waters were receding, started standing up a, hey, if you want to be part of this sort of email distribution list that started as a few hundred, has grown to 2,000, just sharing, hey, here's the information. We stood up a hub base of operations between the Shaws and the drawing board in Montpelier at that vacant lot. And the tents have grown from two the first day to now we're about, I don't know, 20, something like that, of organizations from around the community standing up ready to be there. We've had food brought in from businesses all over the place, just being like, we just want to be here. This is what we know how to do to support our community. It's pretty amazing.
Katie, until just a few days ago, State Street was a river. And then it cleared so quickly, and now what remains? Can you describe for us, and for anybody who's watching the stream who may not be from the area, can you describe for us what it looks like to drive down State Street today?
Well, you can't even drive down State Street, I'll tell you that.
You can't drive down it yet.
The streets are closed, and the store owners and volunteers are clearing out their spaces. There are enormous piles of trash. Everything has been lost. The businesses have lost millions, and the buildings are being cleared and segments being demolished. They have to rebuild from the very start.
How soon does the money come? The government is going to be helping out, but how soon does that money come? Because you need it now.
It's a long waiting period for government money. And so right now, what the business owners really need is funding to get them back on their feet and thinking about the future, paying employees, and just taking a few steps towards the future.
Yeah, and then where are all, I mean, they lost inventory. Like, where is all this inventory right now? And how can we, number one, help them clear it out? And number two, where does it go?
So that's the trash on the street, unfortunately. That is what we're talking about. That is the waste that you're seeing, is people's basements that they use for storage, for bringing things up, all of those were completely flooded. And then it went through, even when they could bring their inventory up to the first floor, it went higher than we had anticipated. And so now everything is wasted. You're seeing businesses down to the studs. And we've got homeowners in Montpelier and Barrie and elsewhere who have the same needs. And we're trying to help them and meet those needs along the way, too.
I don't mean to bring up this word, but COVID. A lot of businesses were adversely affected by COVID. It was a punch in the gut. This is another punch in the gut. We may lose some businesses. Is this true?
This is true. A lot of businesses were just starting to get comfortable, had invested in expansion, and now this disaster, they're really disheartened. And the concept of trying to put all that effort in once again to rebuild from the very start is difficult to wrap their minds around.
Katie, if we want to find the resources and reach out to you, how do we find you?
MontpelierAlive.com/flood2023. And there are so many resources on that page for the community, for volunteers, and we would love to get more people on board with us.
And if somebody's looking for help, can they go there as well?
They can. There's a form to fill out for both residents and businesses, and we will get people there as soon as we can.
Katie, Peter, thank you for joining us today. Best of luck to you. And now I want to bring to the stage...
thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Joyce.
So not used to TV. Are you used to TV?
Joyce LaRosa.
Not used to TV. Joyce LaRosa, you own Cheshire Cat here in town.
I owned the Cheshire Cat with my business partner, Don McConnell. Yes, we bought it in 2020, right before the pandemic.
Oh, boy. Oh, so you dealt with the pandemic, you made it through that, and now this.
Yes, sir. And when we had the pandemic, we changed over to our internet sales. So we are going to be doing that on Monday. That kept us alive during the pandemic. It'll keep us alive now.
Tell me a little bit about what your store was, where it was located.
We just relocated to State Street, put on our big girl pants from Elm Street, and March 1st. So we are a small boutique. Our goal is to provide lovely, artistic women's clothing, accessories, and art and craft. And we're very small and have clients of all ages and sizes.
You walk into your shop. You've been into your shop, yes, since the damage?
We have been in there since Tuesday at 3 o'clock.
Tell me the feeling, tell us the feeling of the first time you walked in there after the storm.
Sure. Well, we probably broke some rules and went through some water and got into the property and did some squeegeeing. It was gross. And
was there a smell? Did it smell? There
oh,
was...
yeah, it did. Luckily, we have power, so we are not seeing that or feeling that any longer. We are pretty well cleaned out, but we'll start testing on Monday.
So you literally get in there with mops and you're doing
yes.
the floor. Well, how much have you had to throw away?
We have been very lucky. We had the ability to pull all of our inventory up to 4 feet. So it remains to be seen if we can keep it all dry and smelling well, but we're very lucky. Unlike my neighbors, it's heartbreaking to walk up and down State Street in Montpelier and Main Street and all the whole state.
What are you seeing for volunteers?
We have had so much food and water brought to us, socks by, I don't remember their names, but
Darn
we
tough.
Have had people who don't even know us. We've had customers. We've had our employees come and say, I'm not here as an employee. I'm here as someone to just help you out. It's been constant. It's been wonderful. It's an amazing community. I just have to say I'm humbled to be here with National Life Group. I worked here for 35 years. They're amazing. Do good, be good, make good. You know, So it's interesting to be on the other side now. My heart is breaking for all of Vermont.
I want to tell you, you're not alone. There's other businesses that are here as well that lost everything too. So thank you for taking a minute to spend time with us. We hope that you're able to just walk away from the chaos a little bit during this time. What do you need from volunteers? Like what, you know, not that you're speaking on all the businesses here that had great losses over the past week, but what is something you really need?
So when I was thinking of this morning, it's not just today. On Monday, we find out next steps. We're going to be painting, and this is just not us. This is going to go on for months and months and months. So I might not need help today, but I might need help a week from now carrying everything back into the shop or out of the shop again. So just keep asking, because one day I may say, I don't need help today, but I direly need it tomorrow. And I say I, but I mean all of us, we.
Is there any concern that after the lights and the cameras and everything goes away, that you'll be forgotten?
Sure, there's always that, but I also know that we have an incredible community, and look how we have built and come together at this point, so I'm pretty sure we'll have that model in place to go out and get the help that we need.
I think we've all found a new meaning to the phrase Vermont Strong, yeah. Especially through this terrible, catastrophic event.
Yeah. Thank you so much for this opportunity to advocate for the community.
Thank you for coming up and hanging out with us.
Anything that we can do, anything. And that total just went up.
Oh, where are we at?
$113,270.
Let's hear it.
Yes. Awesome. Thank you, Joyce, from Cheshire Cat.
Thanks,
Thank
Joyce.
You. Thank you so much.
Boy, I don't know how those talk show hosts do it. I don't know how you kick people off the stage when you're done with them.
You did fine.
I feel bad about Katie and Peter. I'm like, all right, we're done. Get off.
You know, she's not. I do want to bring up, though, like here, Capital Stationers is here tonight. They're a third-generation family business in Montpelier that lost their business or lost things during this flood. Also, Onion River Sports. How many times have we been there? Another business. And I don't need to call all the businesses out. Cornerstone Pub and Brewery as well. They were they were going to do the pub here for the Do Good Festival, the National Life Do Good Fest.
Well, here's where we ask you for money. That's what we need. That's what's going to help. All the money we can get. And the donations are happening at DoGoodFest.com. That's DoGoodFest.com, same place you can stream us, listening to us on Star 92.9, and of course watching on WCAX. Thank you, WCAX, for joining in with us.
Now we're going to go back to the main stage, because coming up next, it is Lovely the Band.
Tossing it over to John Francois.
Hey everybody, what's up? I'm John Francois, your afternoon drive host on Star 92.9. Thank you so much for joining us on Star 92.9, also on Channel 3 WCAX. I gotta tell you, I've lived in Vermont for 5 years, and one of the things I really love about this state is the resiliency. When it counts, when the going gets tough, we come together and help each other out like nobody else I've ever seen. So please give yourself a round of applause for that, because I think that's just absolutely phenomenal. And please keep those donations coming. I mean, it really speaks for itself. I think within the first 14 minutes, we've raised 14K. We're well over 100K right now. So keep them coming at DoGoodFest.com. And honestly, the National Life Group, they could have just canceled everything, but they responded to the moment with this festival. So let's give them a round of applause, please. The National Life Group. Yeah, they're awesome. All right, we're gonna keep the show going. Honestly, I really, really, really fell in love with these guys back in 2017 when they blew up the alternative scene. You probably know them for their hit single, Broken, amongst many others. Please welcome Lovely the Band.
Howdy. Howdy. Let's get situated. Hello. How are we doing? I need to remind myself that we're on television and I cannot swear. I've been telling myself that for the last hour.
Hey, Mitchie. We're on television and you can't swear.
Oh, God. It's a giant swear jar. Except that swear jar is like a fine of $250,000. Anyway. Would it help if I plug my guitar in? I'm nervous. Usually we do these things like on the radio and there's like a delay that's ran. So if I do mess up, then they're like, I was just kidding. Oh God.
How's everyone feeling? Everyone feeling good?
Thanks for having us.
Hello to everyone on the internet and the airwaves and the television. Hi, Mom.
Is she watching?
Probably.
True.
Moms always find the links.
Yeah. I think last time my mom watched a live stream, she was like, "You look like you need to eat less." She didn't say that. Anyway. These are my friends. I love them. These are my friends. I love them. I wish there was a little more love. I'm trying to find a way to fix that. So many people inside my head. My mama taught me not to talk back. But they're pretty good company. Cheers me up when I feel bad. These are my insecurities, and they keep me going. These are my friends. I love them. These are my friends. I love them. And they don't care who you are. They don't care what you do. No. These are my friends. I love them. And I don't get along, and it's something that I'm sad about. Well, everybody needs to pick me up, but I should probably slow it down. But it's pretty good company. Cheers me up when I feel bad. These are my insecurities, and they keep me going. These are my friends. I love them. These are my friends. I love them. And they don't care who you are. They don't care what you do, no. These are my friends. I love them. Shape living in your brain. These are my friends. I love them. These are my friends. I love them. And they don't care who you are. They don't care what you do. No. These are my friends. I love them. Fastball, and I was nervous. I didn't even say hi when I met the singer. I was just like, "I love your band." And he's like, "Thanks, man."
Who are you?
Yeah, he's like, "Do I give you my bags?" He didn't say that.
Keep it running.
Here's another song.
What do you
want to play? I don't. What should we? Let's try that. We'd never done this acoustic, and we learned it about 6 minutes ago. So
back over there.
Here we go.
I
Our foot bends on the 101. Face lights up, she's humming along to my old song on the radio. It's cute as hell, cause she didn't know. And I didn't say, she didn't ask. She's my future, forgive my past. So used to being cynical. She's something like a miracle. It's only a feeling until you make it morning. Cause it's the summer of the buzz cut, but she like my long hair. Or red flags from the pixie dust. It don't matter cause I don't care. Cause I'm falling, I'm falling, I'm falling for you. And I think that you're falling for me too. In the summer of the buzz cut, in the summer of the buzz cut, buzz cut, the summer of the buzz cut, buzz. The same white car with the speakers loud, singing along with the windows down. She lights herself a cigarette. One nail tell her, but she don't know yet. If the secret's out, maybe things will change. I haven't told her my last name. Me and her, no internet. And I still haven't kissed her yet. It's only a feeling until you make it Monday. It's the summer of the buzz cut, but you like my long hair. Oh, red flags turn to pixie dust. It don't matter cause I don't care. Cause I'm falling, I'm falling, I'm falling for you. And I think that you're falling for me too. In the summer of the buzz cut, in the summer of the buzz cut, buzz cut. Summer of the buzz cut, buzz. Sometimes you don't know what you got. Sometimes you don't believe it. Sometimes you don't know what you got until you see her leave it. It's the summer of the buzz cut, but you like my long hair. Red flags turn to pixie dust. It don't matter cause I don't care. Cause I'm falling, I'm falling, I'm falling for you. And I think that you're falling for me too. In the summer of the buzz cut, in the summer of the buzz cut, buzz cut, it's the summer of the buzz.
If this bug on the stage gets any closer, it's going to be the summer of the bug's gut. Sorry.
Nice.
Sorry for that one.
You know, he tried his best.
I'll stick to music.
Jesus Christ. So yeah, we're Lovely the Band from Los Angeles. And you know, thank you to Do Good Fest for having us, and we're even more excited to be here. We could, you know, lend ourselves to the efforts of helping with the crazy flooding and all that that we've heard about. And I just heard there's been like over $100,000 raised. That's pretty awesome. So
yeah, give a hand for yourselves.
Thank you. Right. For those who are donating.
It's amazing.
It's a lot of money. My guitar is out of tune. We just got off the road a few weeks ago, and We were excited to get back up here. Vermont's always been really cool to us, so yeah. Thanks. All right, here's another one. It's called Coachella.
Sunday space and all of those chemicals I snorted right off your chest. All that was beautiful. We were young, we were beautiful. All that was beautiful. We were young, we were beautiful. It's in your head, it's Coachella every week. Free spirits and flowers on your head. I love the way that you laughed with me. I miss the way that you laughed with me. And we said, oh, 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 oh. And we said, my best with you by my side. We danced and we lost ourselves in love and through the night. Oh, that was beautiful. We were young, we were beautiful. Oh, that was beautiful. We were young, we were beautiful. See your head, it's Coachella. Coachella every weekend. Free spirits and flowers on your head. I love the way that you laughed with me. I miss the way that you laughed with me. And we sang, oh, 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 oh. And we sang, season of the sticks, and I saw your mom. She forgot that I existed, and it's half my fault. I just like to play the victim. I'll drink alcohol till my friends want more Christmas. Theme each night of some version of you that I might not have, but I did not lose. Now I'm tired tracks and one pair of shoes.
bones and I'm split in half, but that'll have to do.
Got a few more songs. I'm still nervous.
I don't think my legs stopped shaking since I've been up here.
Yeah, we're just happy to be here. This feels like we're like dinner theater right now, but it's fine. It's like a school talent show, but like in a cool way. I just feel the judgment of parents' eyes on me. And suddenly I'm brought back to high school. I'm just picturing you all. Never mind. We put out a new album in June. It's not about us right now, it's about relief, but if you like our music, you could listen to it if you want. Or don't, you know. It's always a weird thing, you know, plugging yourself at a benefit situation. We're here for the people. Give us our stream our album. I don't know. I'm nervous. When I was younger, they told me that strangers would offer me things that were gonna be bad for me. It wasn't a stranger, it was this blonde girl. She was my best friend, but now she's the death of me. Why'd you go and rip my heart in half? You cut my feelings like arts and crafts. Yeah, you did that. He taught us how to say no with the drugs, but no one warned me about falling in love. I tried everything they said I shouldn't do, but they hit me as hard as falling for you. Yeah, they taught us how to say no with the drugs, but no one warned me about falling in love. I tried everything they said I shouldn't do. It's hit me as hard as falling for you, yeah. It's a sad generation with happy pictures. I still think about you, but I never admit to that. We all got depression, it's covered in stickers, and I talk it out, but there's someone I'll pay for that. Why'd you go and rip my heart in half? You cut up my feelings like arts and crafts. Yeah, you did that. It's hard to how to say no to drugs, but no one warned me about falling in love. I tried everything they said I shouldn't do. Nothing's hit me as hard as falling for you, yeah. For you, yeah. It's hard to how to say no to drugs, but. Yeah, thanks to, you know, Do Good Fest again for having us, and to Star for playing our music.
Yeah.
We heard they've been playing this one, so that's pretty cool of them to do that. It never gets old hearing your song on the radio. It's kind of a weird mind thing. You're just driving, and you're like, huh, I know that guy. I have a funny story about the radio, but I'll say it before the next song so that I have something to say. All right, the song's called Sail Away. Wait, just let me remember how to play it. Hold on. All right, cool.
Sometimes I really wanna sail away. Leave all those things I did yesterday. Is there a place I could stay? Sometimes I really wanna sail away. I get inside my head, too much shit happens. And honestly, I'm past it. I've lost sight of the magic. I think it might be time to break some habits and be a little less dramatic. Past was only practice. I'll tell you how I'm feeling right now. If you want me to let it go, just say so. Sail away. Sometimes I really wanna sail away. Leave all those things I did in yesterday. Is there a place I could stay? Sometimes I really wanna sail away. All my nights are feeling scripted. Smoking things to keep me lifted. It's pain that I'm releasing. And please tell me a lie I can believe in. And offer me some healing. Won't you please give me a reason? I'll tell you how I'm feeling right now. If you want me to let it go, would you say so? Sail away. Sometimes I really wanna sail away. All those things I did in yesterday. Is there a place I could stay? Sometimes I really wanna sail away. Oh, I could use a holiday, just a little getaway. I could really use an escape. I'm sick of feeling stuck inside and trying to find my paradise. I'm just trying to sail away. Sometimes I really wanna sail away. Leave all those things I did in yesterday. Is there a place I could stay? Sometimes I really wanna sail away. Sail away. Sometimes I really wanna sail away. Leave all those things I did in yesterday. Is there a place I could stay? Sometimes I really wanna sail away.
Is anyone else as excited as I am to hear his radio story? I have no idea what he's going to say. Oh, maybe I do.
So, anybody who's excited for the plain white tees?
Woo. Me.
Because honestly, I've been curious about what it's like in New York City. Delilah's here. I would love to know. So this is our last song. We're Lovely the Band. Thank you for having us. Keep donating. Seriously, that's crazy. It's been like over $100,000 raised. That's awesome. It's a lot of money. We're grateful to be here and be a part of this good cause. Stream our new album. Stream our new album if you want.
Hey, Jordan, what's your favorite new album that just came out?
The one by Lovely the Band that you could stream on Spotify.
Or Apple Music.
Or Apple Music.
Or Apple Music.
Or like Amazon.
Amazon.
Or Tidal.
I think you can still buy.
I don't know if anyone uses Tidal. But.
You can still buy music on iTunes, too, so that would be cool.
Yeah. So this is our last song. It was our first song we put out. But so my radio story, like I said, it's always cool hearing your song on the radio. And you know, this was like probably 2019, so the song was like peaking. And I remember I was like in an Uber leaving my house, going to somewhere, meet my friend or something. I'm sitting in the back seat, just like noodling on my phone, as you do. And like I'm just sitting there and I hear our song Broken come on the radio. And in my head, I was like, oh, nice. And then.
Playing it off, though. You're pretty nonchalant.
No, I didn't say anything.
Right.
No. I was just like, in my head, I was like, oh, that's neat. That's cool. Then all of a sudden, my Uber driver was like, oh, I hate this song.
it won't stop playing. I hear it everywhere. I'm like, oh, yeah, man, that band sucks.
Dang.
He got one star. No tip.
Good for speaking his mind, though, I guess. Who knows?
But to each their own. But I don't know if you don't. To each their own. Everyone has their own taste. But, like, if you don't like our band, then you have bad taste.
Put it on a t-shirt.
I just believe that to be true. So, anyway, thanks, guys. We're love with the band. Thanks. This is broken.
I like that you're broken, broken like me. Maybe that makes me a fool. I like that you're lonely, lonely like me. I could be lonely with you. I met you late night at a party. Some trust fund babies, Brooklyn loft, by the bathroom. You said let's talk, but my confidence is wearing off. These aren't my people, these aren't my friends. She grabbed my face and that's when she said, I like that you're broken, broken like me. Maybe that makes me a fool. I like that you're lonely, lonely like me. I could be lonely with you. Something tragic but almost pure. Think I could love you but I'm not sure. There's something wholesome, there's something sweet tucked in your eyes that I love to meet. But these aren't my people, these aren't my friends. And she grabbed my face and that's when she said, I like that you're broken, broken like me. Maybe that makes me a fool. I like that you're lonely, lonely like me. I could be lonely with you. Life is not a love song that we like. We're all broken pieces floating by. Life is not a love song. We could try fix our broken pieces one at a time. I like that you're broken, broken like me. Maybe that makes me a fool. I like that you're lonely, lonely like me. I could be lonely with you. I like that you're broken, broken like me. Maybe that makes me a fool. I like that you're lonely, lonely like me. I could be lonely with you.
Thanks. Thank you.
They are lovely.
Oh, absolutely.
Lovely the band.
Recognize that song. Love
oh, I know.
That song.
I know, yeah. Back in the day. Definitely. Funny guy, too, there on
oh,
the mic.
Oh, yeah, I know. I'm getting a kick out of this. So, yeah, obviously, here to raise money. We have done so in great fashion so far, but the night is certainly not over yet. And I actually have a personal challenge for everybody who might be watching at home, everybody who might be listening in. My family just made a donation. You know, I talked about it with my husband while I was listening to this set. and we basically decided that we both have good jobs. We both were fortunate that we're not in a flooded area.
Yep.
And if the only thing I can do is donate money because I can't make it down there to pick up a shovel and do it myself, then I absolutely should be stepping up at this moment.
There's your challenge.
My challenge to you is to think about whether you can do the same and in what ways you can help out your neighbors, whether it might be picking up a shovel.
Yep.
You know, you might not have the financial means to help out by donating, but we bet that there's a lot of people out there who can't make it to Central Vermont or Southern Vermont or Franklin County or some of those other places, Lamoille County, some of those places that were hit and, want help in some other way.
Yeah, and I just learned, I mean, even people in this room, Kat, are being so generous. The Heading Church in Barrie has said that they have a lot of flood buckets still available. That's going to include things like cleaning supplies, different things that people need to recover from this storm. And stop by. If you need a bucket, they say they've got plenty and they are there for you. Also, you're here for Vermont. We have an updated total right now, $148,378.
That is a good amount, and we know that that number will only keep going up through the night here because we know Vermonters step up for Vermonters and make it happen.
DoGoodFest.com. You can also join in on the fun and the generosity, and we really hope you do tonight.
And again, all that money is going to the Vermont Community Foundation's Vermont Flood Response and Recovery Fund. And that money then gets distributed to local organizations that turn that money into actual action for people. And I actually want to bring on stage Sue Minter from Capstone Community Action in Barrie, one of the organizations that's going to be helping in that recovery. Thank you so much for being here with us
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sue.
So, Sue, talk about what your organization does once money comes in from a recovery fund like this. How do you turn that into something that people can actually use?
Well, I can tell you right now, Capstone staff have been at it all week. Capstone Community Action is an anti-poverty organization, and we help people in crisis. Ultimately, we try to get people out of poverty. But right now, we are distributing food, water, ready-to-go baby formula, clothes. We are going to shelters. We're providing housing counseling. We're providing all kinds of supports for people in crisis. And, you know, we've, in our Lamoille office, we had 200 meals distributed. We had 4 pallets of water, 2 pallets of baby formula, because we run a Head Start. My team told me that they had people coming, a family, a mother who was pregnant, who lived in an apartment, and it was totally flooded, and they had nothing but what they had in their car. They described people feeling like zombies, people who also, though, found hope in the support that we were able to provide and that so many other organizations like Capstone around Central Vermont and statewide are here to be that lifeline.
A lot of heartbreaking stories we've been reporting the entire week here, but you're right. There is just this amazing strength in the state of Vermont, and we all come together during these really big times of crisis. And that also includes Tropical Storm Irene. You were the Irene recovery officer back during that tragedy when that hit Vermont. Can you put this into perspective? How does this compare to what you saw on the ground as the recovery officer then?
Well, for me, there's a lot of flashback. There's a lot of fear, shock, despair. But what I really see is the people on the ground stepping up so quickly. Organizations like National Life right now pivoting their entire Do Good Festival into a fundraiser, already raising over $130,000. Organizations like the Community Foundation already standing up a flood recovery fund. This took weeks and in some cases months during Irene, and it's happening in days and hours. So we are so much more prepared, and it's because of our Vermont strong spirit. And nights like tonight just help me believe in Vermont and that I know we will recover and recover stronger, because this is actually an opportunity for improvement. There's so much challenge on the ground right now, and that's where our heart and soul and money. And the best way people can help if they can't provide labor is through financial support. And that gets turned into so much creative work on the ground immediately, because it takes time for FEMA and the state, the public dollars to come into play for businesses, for farms, for individuals. But the money that we can raise tonight goes out immediately. And that's why we're here tonight.
Sue Minter, thank you so much. And you mentioned the total we have. Well, it's actually gone up.
Awesome.
Yay,
that's
while really we were
awesome.
Standing
yeah, while
here.
We were standing here, $160,000, $581,000.
Yes.
That
we're
is
over
a
$150,000.
Yes.
Do home, do good. Bring it home, Vermont. We are Vermont strong.
We are.
Thank you,
Sue Minter,
Sue.
Thank you so much. DoGoodFest.com. Now, one of the cities that was hit really hard, of course, was Barrie. We'd like to bring on the mayor of Barrie and also a business owner in Barrie as well from Cornerstone Kitchen and Pub, Rich McSheffrey, and the mayor, Jake Hemrick. Thank you so much. I'm just going to point out right now, Mayor, if we can
come
take
on in.
A look.
Yeah, come,
yeah,
on,
come
in.
On in. Thank you. You're covered in mud, so I'm assuming that you've been out there today.
Yeah, we had a huge people-powered volunteer effort today. Hundreds of people throughout Vermont came to Barrie to help out. Obviously, there's just tremendous devastation across the city. People affected, businesses like La Cornerstone, but homes in the floodplain, homes at high elevations that people are still being evacuated today based on erosion damage. And we were cleaning up all day long, and we're going to continue to clean up.
I mean, this is heartbreaking just to look at on TV. I imagine being on the ground, seeing it firsthand is devastating. It's the emotional question, but what goes through your head when you are seeing your beloved city covered in mud?
Oh, it is heartbreaking. And I was up at the Red Cross shelter where people who've just, they've lost everything. They're there. Some of them have brought their animals. Their animals have that anxiety, been rescued in boats. I was cleaning a house near Capstone Community Action today. A woman was trying to sort through the belongings in her basement where, you know, she had her vows, her wedding vows out there, paintings from her grandmother. And I know all of us have those possessions in places, and think of what it would mean to lose that, those types of things. I mean, those are just things, but some people have lost their entire homes in a time when it's so hard to find a home in Vermont.
What is your message to your citizens in Barrie and to the rest of the state?
Well, I mean, I think be Barrie strong. People are turning out, they're showing resilience, and we really need the state's help. Barrie City needs the state's help because we have so many poor people under least resource people are living in floodplains and need the resources that come from the national life, this tremendous fundraising effort. And it's not just us, it's Johnson and Ludlow and Cabot and Montpelier. So thank you.
Now, Rich, obviously your restaurant, the basement flooded, you know, you've lost, what, everything?
We pretty much lost everything. I let Jake borrow my shirt tonight because it was, you know, he came in looking like this. And he asked me to wear his Jordans.
It's comedians.
And we're going to get the plain white tees to autograph those, and we're going to donate those. But no, it's a mess. It feels like, you know, you watch the news every night and you see things that are happening out west. And, you know, those are the times when you're like, you know, I'm glad I don't live in Florida. Or I'm glad I don't live in California. I don't want to deal with that kind of stuff. And here we are, you know. It's like one of the reasons you live in Vermont is because you have that sense of security and that sense of safety. And you feel good about the weather not turning on you. And, you know, you live up on a hill and everything's going to be okay. But all of a sudden, here we are. But the thing is, it's like a light switch in Barrie or Central Vermont or Vermont altogether. It's this. You guys are doing a full repeat interview of Irene. You know, it's the same. It's the same thing. There's a disaster. Everybody drops their stuff. Everybody drops everything they're doing, and they come in. They join together, and we bang it out.
So you actually had that happen to you earlier this week. You put out the call for help to get stuff out of your basement, pump out your basement. What happened after that?
Well, reluctantly. Actually, it's a quick story. My 24-year-old son and his girlfriend are home from Nashville, you know, on vacation. We're going to golf every day and do this and that. And, you know, she never got a chance to eat at the Cornerstone, you know. Like, it all just came on so fast, and they've extended their stay to stay and help. My 75-year-old dad's in the basement shoveling mud. Like, it was crazy. So I got home the first night it happened, and I took my boots off, walked in, and my 18-month-old daughter is running at me with a diaper, dad, and it was like nothing mattered at that point. But my wife is like, you need to ask for help. You never ask for help. And we asked for help, and I was blown away. It was, my brain was jello to watch what happened in this community. And I've watched it before, but not not me asking. Usually I'm on the other end of that, and it's really amazing, and it is truly a good story.
I also just want to point out the generosity of folks in Barrie, because here you are, you've lost so much, and a little birdie told me that you yourself made a donation tonight.
Yeah, we made a donation tonight because karma comes back, and I mean, somebody needs it more than I do. I got hundreds of calls that I turned away, like, we don't need your help, like, go to the next place. And there's a lot of people doing that, and for me to offer up, you know, a few thousand dollars to keep the momentum going is not the end of the world, because we're not done yet. It may be 5 years or 3 years or 10 years, but it all works itself out. It's basically an insurance policy to the Cornerstone brand, knowing that the community is always going to support you, plain and simple.
Now, Mayor, obviously you're listening to one of your business owners, you know, make a generous donation when he's already been hit by this storm. What goes through your head when you see your own people stepping up like that?
Oh, it makes me feel so helpful. And I think one thing everybody can do is renew a commitment to buy local and get downtown, help these businesses get back on their feet. I'm hopeful.
What do you need most? Obviously, everybody can donate tonight. DoGoodFest.com. We can't say it enough. DoGoodFest.com. You can also help. But on the ground, what do your folks need?
Yeah, so we have a volunteer form on the city's website, barriecity.org. People can sign up and register to be a volunteer, connect them to opportunities to serve in the city.
Are there certain things you need the most, certain skills you need the most right now, or is it literally anybody is welcome because they're so neat?
I think it's a strong back. You know, Barrie is a working town and has a lot of hardworking people, and we need more people to join the forces. So,
any message to your fellow business owners?
I mean, to be honest, I was standing over here waiting to come on, and I had to pee really bad, and I went into the bathroom. No, and Lovely the Band was all in there, and there was only three stalls, so I didn't even have anywhere to go. No, but really, I knew that someday in my life I was going to open up for the Plain White Tees, and here we are. No, I'm just be incredibly proud and just keep busting it out and keep rocking it out, and that's what we do, you know. Like, we have plenty of help, you know, but spread it out. Don't everybody bring all their food and donations and pizza and all the stuff to Barrie tomorrow. Like, we're looking good. Like, they're looking for places to get rid of it. In a couple of weeks, we're really going to need things. In 3 weeks, we're going to need something. 5 weeks, we're going to need something. Our food trucks will be out in force doing that, and so will many others. Like, everyone is so quick to respond. Pump the brakes a little bit and make sure you're looking at the guidance throughout the town so you know where to bring stuff and who needs what. Don't overdo it, because this is not going to be an overnight thing. It's going to be a long time coming.
It's a marathon, not a sprint.
It is a long road ahead, for sure. So we want to thank you both, and we certainly wish you luck. And to all of your citizens, your residents, our hearts are with them tonight.
Hey,
and you guys too.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. We should give that guy a mic, though.
I know, right? Doing better than that. We want to do another chat. Oh, wow. Am I supposed to sign that, or am I supposed to get the band to sign that?
Okay. Supposed to get the bands to sign them.
He's auctioning off his shoes.
We were $120, so if we get $130, we're good.
All right.
I bet we'll get more. Yeah, DoGoodFest.com. We can't say that enough.
Yeah,
again.
Speaking of totals, it's gone up. Hey, we like to hear that. Yep. 166, 311. So $166,000.
Awesome.
311. So
all right.
Good.
All right, we got to send it over to Mike Zarni because he's got a special band to play.
Oh yeah.
Very special. Very special. Thank you guys. Thank you, Kat. Thank you, Darren. Hey guys, how you doing? You know what? Your water looks a little bit low there. I'll get you topped off. I'll take care of that. My name is Mike Zarni from Mike and Mary in the Morning on Star 92.9. Good evening. Good evening, Mike. Hi. You know, I got to tell you, one of the most striking images for me of all the images that we've seen is the one of that drone flying over the Crown Plaza, going over the center of Montpelier. And I was literally parked in that parking lot a month ago. It was amazing for me to see an ocean where I was just parked, at a hotel that I was just in. And so this is something that we need to help with. This is something we gotta take care of, and we can by going to DoGoodFest.com, making a donation. We're gonna need a lot of money, and we're gonna need some time, but we're gonna get this fixed, because we are Vermont strong, yes? All right. Ready for some music? More music? Lovely the band, Fastball. Let's hear it for those guys. These guys, you know them for their songs, Hey There, Delilah, Rhythm of Love, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. There we go. They are from the state that I was actually born in, Lombard, Illinois. Let's give it up for the Plain White Tees.
Thank you guys so much. Woo! We are the Plain White Tees. It is amazing to be here with you guys tonight. So part of such a good cause. And I know things got a little bit pivoted here. So we're really glad that this could still happen. And thank you all for being here. And everybody, well, I don't know where the cameras are, but everybody watching at home, thank you so much for tuning in, supporting such a good cause. Yeah, like I said, we're just really stoked to be here and to be a part of it. So thank you guys. This is this next song is a love song. Goes out to everybody watching here and wherever you are.
There's only one thing to do, three words for you. I love you.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
give me more loving than I've ever had. Make it all better when I'm feeling sad. Tell me that I'm special even when I know I'm not. Make me feel good when it hurts so bad. Barely getting mad, I'm so glad I found you. I love being around you. You make it easy. It's easy as one, two, one. There's only one thing to do. Tell me things you never even tell your closest friend. Make me feel good when I hurt so bad. Best that I've had, I'm so glad I found you. I love being around you. You make it easy. It's easy as one, two, one, two. There's only one thing to do. Three words for you.
We love you guys. Thank you so much.
Cheers.
So you guys, Plain White Tee is putting out a new album at the end of this year. Give it up. Come on. We're very excited about it. Very excited about the new songs. So if it's cool with you, we're going to play a couple new songs tonight. Is that cool? This is, I feel like Tim is the most excited about this next one. Right? Yeah. To me, it's like definitely top 12 or so, for sure. I love it. But I hope you guys love it. It's called Would You Even? It goes like this.
Almost fell asleep on the drive home. I wonder if you would give a all these damn old songs on my iPhone. And if I died, then none of them would ever be in. Hey! Hey! Can't believe you said that about me. You're always good at tearing me down. Now you're trying to call and say, sorry, I guess I got no choice. Now I'm turning around. Driving back to your house, it's almost daylight. I doubt these words will help, but I'm hoping that they might. And if I pour my heart out, would you even listen? And if we end it all now, would you even miss it? Would you even?
my heart and now it's all scarred up. You're pretty good in love, but you're better at fights. Driving back to your house, it's almost daylight. I'll tell these words will help, but I'm hoping that they might. And if I pour my heart out, would you even listen? And if we end it all now, would you even miss it? Would you even? Hey, would you even? Hey, why do I do this to myself? Why do I do this to myself? Why do I do this to myself? Driving back to your house, it's almost daylight. I doubt these words will help, but I'm hoping that they might. And if I pour my heart out, would you even listen? And if we end it all now, would you even miss it?
Thank you.
Hey.
Hey. Hey, everybody, give it up real quick. Tim's gonna sing this next song. Give it up for Tim.
Come on. Hey.
This song's called The Giving Tree. It's about losing a long relationship of mine. It was about 10 years of my life, and this is the song I wrote when it was ending. It goes like this. One, two.
All the leaves on the giving tree have fallen, no shade to crawl in underneath. I've got scars from a pocket knife where you carved your heart into me. If all you wanted was love, why would you use me up, cut me down, build a boat and sail away, when all I wanted to be your giving tree. Settle down, build a home and make you happy. Well, I lie in the dead of night and I wonder whose covers you're between. And it's sad laying in his bed, you feel hollow, so you crawl home back to me. All you wanted was love, why would you use me up, cut me down, build a boat and sail away, when all I wanted to be was your giving tree. Settle down, build a home and make you happy.
Well, I see a trail that starts a line of broken hearts behind you that lead you back to me. The one sad and lonely fool with nothing left but roots to show. Oh, all you wanted was love, why would you use me up, cut me down, build a boat and sail away, when all I wanted to be was your giving tree. Settle down, build a home and make you happy. Settle down, build a home and make you happy.
Thank you.
All right, we're gonna do another new one, you guys. Oh yeah. You should get excited. Mere title alone sets you up for what you're in store for. This is called Fired Up. Let's do it.
I'm fired up and I feel a lot better now. Sun coming up and I feel like going out. Fill up my cup and I smile when I look around. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, sing it with me now. I'm fired up and I feel a lot better now. Sun coming up and I feel like going out. Fill up my cup and I smile when I look around. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, sing it with me now. I forever wanna feel like my head's up flying in the clouds.
In the clouds!
I forever wanna feel like I feel and I never ever wanna come down. I'm fired up. I'm fired up. I'm fired up. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, sing it with me now. I'm fired up and I feel a lot better now. Sun coming up and I feel like going out. Up my cup and I smile when I look around. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, singing with me now. I forever wanna feel like I'm hyped up surfing on the crowd. I forever wanna feel like I feel and I never ever wanna come down. I'm fired up. Ooh, I'm fired up. Ooh, yeah, I'm fired up. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, singing with me now.
I feel
so bright,
so bright.
No rain
inside.
I'm good.
All right.
If you're feeling what I'm feeling, sing it. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, sing it with me now. I'm fired up. Feel a lot better now. Sun coming up and I feel like going out. Fill up my cup and I smile when I look around. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, sing it with me now. I'm fired up and I feel a lot better now. Sun coming up and I feel like going out. Fill up my cup and I smile when I look around. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, sing it with me now. I'm fired up. Ooh, I'm fired up. Fired up. Yeah, I'm fired up. I'm fired up.
I saw some people standing and dancing back there. Thank you very much. Oh, yeah. Yeah, by the way, you guys don't have to sit down the whole time. I'm just saying. If you feel like standing, dancing, that's on you.
You're everything I wanted.
little dead friendly. Hey! All I wanted was your love, 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 love. Hate is a strong word, but I really, really, really don't like you.
Really don't like you.
Now that I'm sober, I don't even know what I liked about you.
Liked about you.
Brought you around, and you just brought me
you guys. You guys feeling good or what? Good, because we got a few more songs for you.
Go easy on the mosh pit, guys.
Yeah. We don't want anybody getting hurt out there, okay? Well, we're going to slow it down for this one. So this will be a nice, like, no, you can stay. It's still, you can dance. So he's like, slow dance? No way. She was ready to crowd surf a second ago, I think. So this is a kind of new song. We actually put this one out in February. So if there's any diehard fans out in the crowd. Wait, is this the right song? Yeah. Any diehard fans out in the crowd or anybody at home watching that has, you know, been following us on social media, follow us on Spotify or whatever, you guys would know this one. So it goes out to anybody that knows it. This is called Spaghetti Tattoo. It goes like this.
Driving in from Malibu, reservation made for two. Stuck in traffic, be there soon. Throw some money in the meter, 15 minutes late to meet her, running past the movie theater. Nervous in the elevator, will I like her, will I hate her, will she leave me for the waiter? But there you are, waiting for me at the bar. All my worries disappear, cause we're here. Oh, take it easy, let it flow. Don't know where it's gonna go, but it feels good not to know. Smiles and making jokes. Don't know where it's gonna go, but it feels good not to know.
Yeah.
We sit down and order drinks, talk about your favorite things, play guitar but you can't sing. Your favorite movie's Dumb and Dumber. Drink champagne for a whole summer when you broke up with that drummer. There's no pressure, no forever. I'm just glad
glad to be together. Love to get to know you better. Cause we're here, yeah, we're here. Been DMing for a year. All my worries disappear. Cause we're here. Oh, take it easy, let it flow. Don't know where it's gonna go, but it feels good not to know. Oh, cracking smiles, I'm making jokes. Don't know where it's gonna go, but it feels good not to know. Conversations about art, a spaghetti tattoo on your arm. Yeah, we talked until the restaurant lights came on. We say our goodbyes and you say let's do this again soon. Yeah, I really hope we do. Oh, take it easy, let it flow. Don't know where it's gonna go, but it feels good not to know. Oh, cracking smiles and making jokes. Don't know where it's gonna go, but it feels good not to know. Don't know where it's gonna go, but it feels good not to know.
Hey, hey, spaghetti a tattoo. That was some really good dancing, you guys. Yes. No, thank you. Thank you. You guys have been practicing that, really? I mean, I could tell. I could tell. Are you guys still feeling good? I'm sorry. Are you guys feeling good? Okay, good. Because this song goes out to you. It's called Happy. I wanna feel good. Say we're feeling so bad. I wanna be happy, happy, happy. What's the point of being sad? Yeah, yeah, I wanna feel good. Got this day and I don't wanna waste it. Wanna have fun without getting wasted. Love the thrill of the chase, so I'll chase it. Yeah, chasing. There ain't no rain falling. Got all my friends calling. I need a little sunshine up on my face. Cruising up PCH, sounds like the perfect day. Yeah, I wanna feel good. Sick of feeling so bad. I wanna be happy, happy, happy. What's the point of being sad? Yeah, yeah, I wanna feel good. In the sky shine like we can. Every day, every night is the weekend. You and I, we could dive off the deep end. Off the deep end. Cause ever since I saw you, I couldn't wait to call you. I need a little moonlight up on my face. You on my pillowcase. Sounds like a perfect day, yeah. I wanna feel good. Sick of feeling so bad. I wanna be happy, happy, happy. What's that point of being sad? Yeah, yeah, I wanna feel good. I got this day and I don't wanna waste it. I'm loving life and I want to embrace it. Feeling this feeling, I don't wanna shake it. Wanna shake it, I wanna feel good. I'm sick of feeling so bad. I wanna be happy, happy, happy. I just wanna be happy, happy, happy. I wanna feel good. good.
All right, you guys, we got time for two more songs. Oh, yeah. And since this is like a virtual thing, we're not going to like leave. Normally, we'd be like, all right, good night. We love you guys. And then make you like clap and be like, one more song, one more song, one more. Oh, stop, you guys. Oh, my God. You're so nice. How about two more songs? Two more songs. 17 more songs. No.
Whoa.
Listen, we only have time for one more, but we're going to do two anyway, okay? How about that? Let's all sing along so the people at home can feel the love in the room, okay? This is Hey There, Delilah. You gotta make them feel it.
Hey there, Delilah, what's it like in New York City? I'm 1,000 miles away.
You guys know this one, right?
Times Square can't shine as bright as you. Don't be shy, I swear it's true. Hey there, Delilah, don't you worry about that distance. I'm right there if you get lonely. Give this song another listen. Close your eyes. Listen to my voice, it's my disguise. I'm by your side.
Everybody, come on.
Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 What you do to me. Hey there, Delilah, I know times are getting hard. Just believe me, girl, someday I'll pay the bills. With this guitar, we'll have it good. We'll have the life we knew we would. My word is good. Hey there, Delilah, I've got so much left to say. If every simple song I wrote to you would take your breath away, I'd write it all. Even more in love with me, you'd fall. We'd have it all. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 1,000 miles seems pretty far. They've got planes and trains and cars. I'd walk to you if I had no other way. Our friends would all make fun of us. We'll just laugh along because we know that none of them have felt this way. Delilah, I can promise you, by the time we get through, the world will never ever be the same. You're to blame. Hey there, Delilah, you good, and don't you miss me. Two more years and you'll be done with school. I'll be making history like I do. You'll know it's all because of you. We can do whatever we want to. Hey there, Vermont, here's to you.
Hey,
Hey. Mom's on the FaceTime here. Hi, Mom. It's not my mom, it's his mom. Hello. Hey, Vermont. You guys have been through a lot this week. We're so stoked to be here to help in any way that we can. But you know what really helps is just singing and letting it out and just having a good time, smiling again. That's what it's all about. So we're happy to bring that to you guys. Like I said, that's our little bit that we can do. So let's all sing this last chorus of Hey There Delilah together as loud as we can and just feel good for a change, okay? Oh, it's what you do to me. Oh, it's what you do to me. We got one more song, by the way. But first, oh, it's what you do to me, as loud as we can. On four or five. Four, and then we do it. Ready? One, two, three, four.
Oh, it's what you do to me. Oh, it's what you do to me. Everybody, come on. What you do to me.
Keep going.
Oh, 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 oh,
love you guys. Thank you so much, guys.
All right, this is gonna be our last tune. You guys are super fun. Let's keep it going. Keep the dancing going. This song's called Rhythm of Love.
Stuck in the clouds, she begs me to come down, says, boy, quit fooling around. I told her I love the view from up here, warm sun and wind in my ear. Will watch the world from above as it turns to the rhythm of love. We may only have tonight, but till the morning sun, you're mine. Oh, all mine. Play the music low and sway to the rhythm of love. Well, my heart beats like a drum, a guitar string to the strum of a beautiful song to be sung. Like the sea, they roll back when she's laughing at me. She rises up like the tide, the moment calypso mine. We may only have tonight, but till the morning sun, you're mine. All mine. Play the music low and sway to the rhythm of love. We can dance in slow motion, and all your tears will subside. All your tears will
ba-ba.
And long after I've gone, you'll still be humming along, and I will keep you in my mind, the way you make love so fine. We may only have tonight, till the morning sun, you're sway to the rhythm of love. Oh, play the music low and sway to the rhythm of love. Yeah, sway to the rhythm of love.
Love y'all.
That's great. That is awesome. That is awesome.
That is incredible.
That's a beautiful number we're looking at right now.
All right, Plain White Tees, everybody.
Plain White Tees. That was great.
What a successful evening, but it's not over yet at all. It is not over yet. Please, if you are here, stay seated just for a little bit because we are tallying things up right now.
We're tallying. You know, it's funny, I told you a few hours ago, I was like, Mary, this thing's going to be over before you know it.
I know.
Here we are. Look at that, how quickly it went by.
It went by in a flash, it did.
What a beautiful night. So, Fastball, Lovely the Band,
Plain White Tees,
raising money with National Life Group Do Good Fest for flood relief.
That's
ready
right.
for a number? Are
you
we ready?
Oh, yeah. You ready to give this up so far?
I can't believe we're only $2 short of the bigger number. We're only $2 short of... We need somebody to donate $2 right now to put this thing up.
We do need $2 before we read this stuff. Do you have $2? All right, Darren Perrin's got $2.
Darren Perrin's got $2.
If he gives us $2, that number is what?
It puts us to
$300,000!
Yeah!
Yes!
$300,000, man. That is fabulous.
So you know who we need to tell.
So that is a drop in the bucket.
That's right. That's right. And we need to share that news.
Yeah.
With Mehran Asadi.
Who?
Mehran Asadi.
Who's that?
He is the chairman, the CEO, and the president of National Life Group.
Come on, Mehran. Let's hear from Mehran. Mehran.
Look at the number.
Pretty awesome, isn't it?
How you doing, man?
I'm doing great, man. I'm so excited. Remember, at the beginning of the night, my projection was 500.
Yeah, we're 300,000, so that's
300,000.
Pretty darn close.
Also, folks who are actually writing a check, we have another 100,000 already. So that's 400.
You're making it 400,000.
400, yeah.
400,000.
400,000.
We need Vermonters to pitch in to get us to 500, because you know what happens when we get to 500. National Life will match it dollar for dollar for a cool total of $1 million.
$1 million.
That
not a bad night.
That's a drop in the bucket.
Yes.
That is definitely a drop in the bucket.
That is a bad night. Right?
Not a bad night at all.
Thank you. Thanks to you guys.
Thank you.
Let's just keep this thing going. Yep. Our neighbors need help.
You know, I'm glad you said that. Because just because the music is over right now doesn't mean the donations are done.
Right.
You can go anytime to dogoodfest.com to make a donation. When we're all done doing this and the people of Montpelier are still squeegeeing and mopping.
And shoveling.
Throwing away product for businesses.
Mm-hmm.
This is going to help. And the donations can keep coming in.
That's right. Awesome. Vermont Community Foundation, Vermont Flood Response Recovery Fund, that's what this money is going towards. It's going to help fund people's products, right? It's going to help fund people coming in to volunteer and cleaning up. Just the money is what we need.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And thanks for everybody to be here. I love my teammates at National Life. You guys are awesome. Thank you.
And your team did put a lot of work into this. We really appreciate everything that they did.
Amazing.
Well, yeah, thank you to National Life Group.
Thank you so much.
Thank you to WCAX.
So we want to thank WCAX right now and bring Kat and Darren up.
Come on up, guys.
Hey.
Wonderful. Honestly, what a wonderful turnout. What a wonderful dollar turnout. Yeah.
When we started here earlier, it was $10,000?
Yeah, something like 14 when we did the first update. Yeah.
15 minutes in, we were at 14.
Yeah.
400.
That's amazing.
That is.
We're at $400,003, but we're just another $3.
Oh, I grabbed that too. So
the two. So we'll
five.
We'll take. All right.
That's
so we got a $2
bill. Who has
$2 bill? Look at that.
Who has $2 bills anymore?
He has a $2 bill.
I actually had to borrow it because my wallet's in the car.
You should probably sell it on eBay and make
that's
some money on
$2,
that.
$2, here it goes.
I know, I'm serious.
But honestly, we know Vermonters turn out for Vermonters, and this number is just one example of that. And the National Life's generous, you know, match of that. If we hit the half a million, they'll match the other.
So I know.
Yes.
I
always, yes.
Yeah, we do. I feel like Vermont is a community. It's not like one county here, one county there. Like all of Vermont is like one county. I always feel like that. You know, you have the whole state coming together to help Central Vermont, to help Ludlow, to help Johnson. Everybody needs the help.
I mean, that's the beautiful part. I mean, I grew up here, and I just know that, you know, when your neighbor's in need, you help. But also, if you travel over the mountain, that guy might need a hand as well, and that's what we do.
And just like it was said earlier tonight, that maybe not everything today or tomorrow, next week somebody will need help. A month from now, painting their business, setting it up. I mean, the help is going to go on. There's places that you can go to sign up to volunteer, but you got to keep with the money. Got to keep with the money.
Yeah, I mean, and it's, I don't know about Darren. I'm going to speak for myself here, but just seeing these images come through, you kind of feel like, I what can I do? Yeah. You can't not see a flooded business scraping, you know, the mud off their floor and throwing away the things that they chose so carefully to sell to their customers because they really care about what they do, and not feel like I would like to do something right now.
Well, also, like the mayor was saying earlier tonight when we were chatting with him, that he was at a place earlier today, and this woman was like scraping the mud off her wedding vows, scraping the mud off her photos. And it's just even those small things, but those things that mean so much. You know, aside from the loss of your business, the loss of your car, the loss of your belongings, those things are also gone. And we have to keep that in mind as well.
One of the things I noticed, I'm sorry, go ahead, Kat.
Oh, I wanted to say that number just went up. $403,000, oh. 308.
All right. 308, as we speak. As we're speaking.
DoGoodFest.com is your place to go to make a donation right now, and it goes to the Vermont Community Foundation's Vermont Flood Response and Recovery Fund. So again, that is where your money is going. It's really important, I mean, in these times, to also know where your money is going when you donate, because you want to make sure that every dollar you donate gets used in a way that actually helps people and gets used responsibly.
And we learned tonight that that's exactly what's going to happen. This money is going to go to homes, to businesses, to communities that are really, they've been pounded, they've been hit hard, and this is across the state. We've seen it at the top of the state, we've seen it in southern Vermont. This storm did not miss any community.
Like you said, there's even a place where people can get buckets and kits to help them clean up, right?
Right, so yeah, I was just gonna say, Heading Church in Barrie, they got 52 pallets of flood buckets, 1,800 flood buckets. Each flood bucket has cleaning supplies and pumps and masks, gloves, everything that somebody might need to clean up their home. And they're at the Heading Church in Barrie right now. I mean, the gentleman came up and told me that tonight, so go get your buckets, literally. Yeah.
When I watch WCAX's coverage of the flood damage, not only do we see the damage, but the underlying tone of every story is Vermonters coming together. Vermonters helping Vermonters. People showing up from towns not even close to Montpelier to help out. Yeah. That's what we're all about here in Vermont. Yeah.
And I think it's also, though, it's kind of important to think about, though. Sometimes people say, oh, well, then somebody else is doing the work, right? So I don't have to. Clearly, that's already being taken care of, right? So I don't have to do anything. No, actually, there's a lot more to be done. And that's where sometimes a donation can come in if you can't get to somewhere like Barrie or somewhere like Montpelier. Or Londonderry, or anywhere else that was hit.
Right. And I know that you could go on the state website and also Montpelier Alive, and if you want to volunteer, you can sign up to volunteer. Because I remember thinking, do I just drive down there, park my car, and walk next to a business? Like, how do I jump in and help?
Well, even a lot of state officials are saying the best thing to do is to go on to one of those sites. You shouldn't just show up, and you shouldn't, because that's not really an organized effort. And so a lot of the state officials are saying, get on to a legit site and then volunteer that way. Or, and also, donate. DoGoodFest.com.
And we want to give a shout out to Scott Rogers for donations tonight. Yeah.
Scott Rogers put a lot of work into this tonight. Yes.
Huge effort. I mean, the donation of time, the donation to put in your effort into organizing something like this that can have such a wide-ranging impact is huge. Yeah.
And you know, like you mentioned earlier, Kat, if you can't pick up a shovel, maybe you're unable to help in a physical way, monetarily, that's what you can do. Go, like you called your husband, let's do this, let's give some money. You go to dogoodfest.com, give a few bucks if you can't pick up a shovel or a sponge and help out.
I think what I've always thought, you know, and one of the reasons I called my husband, I said, you know, like you can chase that feeling, you know, the fuzzy feeling you get when you help people, the kind of warm and fuzzies? Chase that feeling right now because it's actually the easiest way that you can feel like, hey, I helped the state move forward from this.
And people are doing it financially because it just went up again to $403,472.
We're inching our way up there. Again, we get to that $500,000 mark. National Life Group's going to match it. We're going to get up to $1 million.
Think about what $1 million will do for this state after this.
I mean, that's the other thing. I mean, we can double the amount of good that could happen tonight if we get to that mark. We've got to get to the 500,000 mark tonight.
We're getting live updates, obviously, as we speak. We've got our crew here working behind the scenes, jotting the numbers down for us as we're doing this, and the numbers just keep going up, which is great news. People are watching, people are becoming a part of this and helping out.
Yeah, dogoodfest.com.
I was gonna say, I mean, when you think about what a dollar does, you know, if I go into a store and I spend money, if it's a local store, that dollar stays local. But if you think about what a dollar can do when an organization has the resources to make that dollar stretch further, you've heard the food shelf, you know, they always say, we can make a dollar get this amount of things. That's kind of like what we're doing right here. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, honestly.
Exactly.
Dogoodfest.com. It's helping the Vermont Community Foundation, Vermont Flood Response and Recovery Fund 2023.
I have to say that the amount of energy in the room earlier tonight, it's been really good. So also a shout out to all of you. You know, it's sort of a smaller space, but it felt like a party.
Yeah. It felt like a big party. And, you know, I have to say a lot of the people that are here are business owners that lost businesses in the flood and lost money or homes or cars. And for them to come out here and spend a moment away, a moment to pause, I keep saying, that's what I call it, a moment away from the chaos, just to spend some time having a good time, enjoying the music and putting a smile on their face. I mean, there's the warm and fuzzy.
You know, it's interesting, the process of what has happened, what has transpired over the past few days. Just few days. Got to send a shout out to John Mullet, our GM over at Star 92.9, for being a big part of putting this all together. Yeah. Because a week ago, we were looking at doing a show in front of 10,000 people with the Plain White Tees, Fastball, Lovely the Band, bunch of people out on the lawn, gonna be a great day raising money for Branches of Hope.
That's right, but that didn't happen.
Tuesday, we get in, we've got the rain going on, we're hearing about the flooding, we transition our show entirely away from the fun stuff, and we're not good at being serious.
Honestly.
We did the whole show about, you know, cancellations and everything that was happening in our neighborhoods.
But we had 3 days or 4 days. We had 4 days.
What do we do? Right. What do we do with this concert? How can we help? How can we help? Which evolved into meetings, which evolved into National Life Group and John Mullet and Mirren getting together and saying, we're going to do this. We're going to figure it out. So they did. They said, let's get some TV cameras. Let's get Darren and Kat.
I know, right?
Shout out to Jay Barton, our general manager, for saying,
thank you, Jay.
Let's get WCAX in on this. And he's actually the one updating our numbers right now.
Go ahead.
Thank you, Jay. Right,
$406,580. Again, that number
keeps going up.
We love it.
Yeah, let's get this. Let's keep it moving. It's so easy to make. It's so easy to make that donation. The QR code is right on the screen, or you go to dogoodfest.com and you make your donation. And I don't know, what's the population in Vermont?
About 680,000, I think.
The whole. Okay, so if everybody put in a dollar.
Yeah, we would be here.
Just
$1.
Everybody.
$1, folks.
Everybody now, please.
Yeah, I mean, you can take $5 for your cup of coffee that you would have gotten at Starbucks or something and say, I'll have one less cup of coffee and make sure that a business can help recover.
Or the change that you pull out of your pocket, right? That's sitting in the jar on your desk or whatever.
Yeah.
I can't emphasize enough that when we're done yapping and thanking everyone for helping us out with raising this money, when we are done, it is not done. Do Good Fest goes on. Dogoodfest.com. Make a donation tomorrow. Maybe you're not getting paid until midweek. and you want to donate 10 or 20 bucks, whatever, $5, you wait till next Wednesday. It's still waiting for you at dogoodfest.com.
You know, this morning I went to the farmer's market in Burlington, and, you know, the Intervale, where they had all their crops sort of, yeah, flooded, they pulled as many crops out as they could before the flood hit. Yeah. So at the farmer's market, they were selling it, and the line was like around the corner to buy from them. And when people were donating while they were buying their food. I mean, that's what this is about.
And a lot of these farmers are not going to be able to plant again this season. So you got to buy local. You got to stick local. Stick with your neighbors and donate to your neighbors tonight. DoGoodFest.com.
Our general manager is giving a challenge to other general managers. Doesn't matter what business you're in. $1,000.
$1,000 from Jay.
Okay.
Thank you, Jay.
And I think somebody just did that and took the challenge because the number just went up to $407,000, $580,000, $407,580 right now.
That is awesome. Awesome. It is.
Now, we've seen a lot of things. What has struck you guys as the most, what's the most striking image you've seen from this whole thing? I remember the drone footage I was mentioning earlier flying over the Crown Plaza Hotel.
Any drone footage is incredible because there's a scope that comes with the aerial views that I don't think that you get on the ground. But at the same time, if you're in front of someone's driveway and there's a cavern through their driveway because their entire, and you know they're on a back road, they're not going to be anyone's first priority. It's going to take them a while. They might be stuck in their house for a few days, and they might not get the same level of help that other people do. Sometimes it's those images that are really at home that really stick with you because you're going, what if that was me? What if that was me, and that was my driveway, and that was my home, and maybe I didn't have a lot of money, and I'm looking at, you know, tens of thousands of dollars of repairs, and I'm going, how do I do this? And that's what organizations like this make happen, is the how do I do this?
For me, it was the cars and the campers that were flooded and swept under bridges.
Floating around, going under the bridges, yeah.
Yeah, for me, I think it was, well, in addition, we sent Alyssa Borden up in a plane and captured all of that for that view that you were talking about, Kat, that bird's eye view. But Catherine Huntley, one of our reporters, was up in Calais, and that town is, you know, one of those towns.
They got tore up.
And these back roads are the ones that are going to take a really long time to get to. She was standing in this thing, and it was like, you know, 10 feet above her. That's just how deep it had cut there. So that one stuck out to me. Mud coming out of businesses has stuck. It's just heartbreaking.
And we do want to get to one more total here. I'll let you do the honors, Mary.
Okay, $414,220.
Yes!
And again, it is not over today, though.
It's not over today. DoGoodFest.com to make a donation. Let's keep this growing, because you know what happens once it hits $500,000.
Thank you to National Life Group for doubling that when we reach that $500,000 mark to make $1 million. So thank you, National Life Group. Thank you, WCAX, Kat and Darren.
That's
great,
right.
To work with you tonight.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Vermont.
Vermont strong.
Vermont strong.
Let's make some noise, people.